done our first HIV to HIV liver transplant.
Yeah.
What about that?
The first in the world. It's very exciting.
Was it the first in the world?
In the world.
Really?
Yeah. There had been a few kidneys done in South Africa, so my colleague Elmi Muller started that program there, and we actually did the first liver in the world and the first kidney in the U.S.
That legislation that you were so involved with has really turned out to come to fruition.
It was a six-year mission, you know, to show the need, show the impact, write the bill, get the bill passed, bring it back here, set up the policies, set up the safety protocols and things like that, and then actually do it. I mean, what's most exciting, though, is that two people were taken off the waiting list. Who would not have been taken off the waiting list were these organs not available to them.
What were some of the barriers to getting this passed?
So just getting on the radar was the hardest thing, and we did that old-fashioned, you know, selling Girl Scout cookies. I mean, we just went door to door, talked to anyone that would listen, and once we got on the radar, that was it. Then it was a no-brainer, and you know, they knew it would be one of the only laws that actually passed.
So many people are going to benefit from this. And here's something that occurred to me, and I'd like to hear what your thoughts are.
Yeah.
What about people who are not HIV positive? If you said to me, hey, Elizabeth, you have liver failure, you need a liver. And you said to me, the only organ I have available is one that is from somebody who has HIV. Would you be able to say to me, hey, it's going to be better for you to take this liver than to wait and see if you can find an organ that's not HIV positive?
That's a great question. And I suspect that will eventually happen. The law actually doesn't allow it now. The law only allows positive to positive. And I think there are actually enough HIV positive people on the list or in need of an organ that we're going to use up that supply.
What's the estimate with regard to the number of people who are likely to benefit from this? All those people who are going to get off the list, how many people is that?
Before the law passed, we never tracked the HIV positive status of people on the list because it was irrelevant. And we never tracked HIV positive donors because it was illegal. And so if there was an HIV positive donor, it wouldn't even get recorded. Based on what we know from prevalence of liver disease and kidney disease in HIV positive people, there are thousands of people out there who could benefit from a transplant.
You think as all this data comes in, you're going to be switching careers to full-time legislation changing rather than being a deal?
No, my primary concern is the patients that we take care of. I mean, this was a project that was motivated by our need, the need of our patients. We had HIV positive patients on the list and we're trying to get them transplanted, and I watched organs get thrown away, and I said, we have to help these folks, and we have to help folks like them all across the country.
Excellent.